But there was strong support for this. Only, yeah, very, very strong support, by far.
Dani says, he's between a rock and roll, but I don't understand it. If he says yes, then there's a lot of explanation to do. And if he says no, there's an equal amount of explanation to do. So I said to him, thank you.
At a meeting of the Council of the University of the Free State, today, the 23rd of November, the Council approved the following with regards to the MT staying statute. Firstly, the relocation of the MT staying statute in full consultation with the Stain family. Secondly, the process of relocation will take place in a dignified manner. Thirdly, the necessary legislation processes set out by the Free State Heritage Resources Authority will be followed. And lastly, project caring becomes a crucial focus for 2019 and beyond, with the institutional multi-stakeholder group as a management platform to conceptualize and drive the project. The terminology caring will be fully defined in due course.
So thank you, Mr. Lowe. I can just indicate to the media that, and also to the community out there, that the decision that council reached at the end of the day wasn't a very easy decision. It was a very robust discussion. It was a tough decision to take. But the sort of guiding principle that we used was what would be for the best interest of the university. And that was the guiding framework that was always converts back to be able to reach this decision. I also just would like to say that the process itself can easily be broken down in about four areas.
The one area was when the request was initially made, and it was dated back as far as 2003, when this first issue of the removal of the stained statue was made. It was subsequently emphasized during the Rhodes Must Fall movement and campaign by the students to management, and specifically this year, when I had a student engagement, the students asked that the stained statue be removed. What we were able to do was to say that whatever we're going to do, whether we remove the statue, or whether the statue will stay where it is at the moment, or whether it will be relocated to another place on campus, that will be done in a manner that should happen at universities. It's about an educational process. It is about a process where we would like to hear the different views, the different perspectives, and we also would like to create the platforms for those perspectives to come to the fore. And the first, the second process then, after the request was made, was a conversation regarding the future of the stained statue. And that conversation stretches over about 7 months period. It process. It about the different perspectives in the media. And I could say it was covered by most of the media houses. It was also covered in various television programs. We also had expert advice provided by experts in the field of artwork, symbols, monuments, and spaces. So that all provided and given input into the process of consultation. I would like to add that I appointed a task team to manage this whole process, and the task team was critically part of this consultation process. In fact, they spearheaded the consultation process. That led up to recommendations that the task team made to the executive. The executive deliberated that and made a recommendation to council, and that was the recommendation that was amended a bit, but was ultimately approved by the Council of the University of the Free State. The very important aspect that one should focus on now is what really happened after the decision has been taken. And the decision was taken earlier today by the Council of the University. And therefore, it is important for all stakeholders to understand that it's not about who lose, or who has lost and who won and who would win and who was on the winning side. It's really about that future that we would like to craft ourselves as stakeholders of the university, and that include all stakeholders, even the alumni, because they are also key stakeholders of the university, to craft that new, what we discussed in the council meeting, that new university citizenship. A citizenship that probably could also spearhead a conversation of what a South African, a new South African citizenship should be all about. So it's not about I'm right or I'm wrong, or I have to give up and I have to compromise, or I have to reconcile and maybe the extent of reconciliation is not at the level where it should be. It is about crafting and respecting where we came from, was different as different individuals, as different cultures, and how do we take the university forward? And that is the new university citizenship. And the chair of council has mentioned about the project caring, and that is what we discussed could be the basis of how we take the future forward. It's a value that is supposed to be neutral, but it's a value that measures the strength of every individual. So if you have a culture, we need to make sure that culture is being cared, but in respect to yourself, it is about because we care about one another, and that's the reason why we're doing that. So for us, that new university citizenship is going to be quite crucial in making sure that the decision that was taken today is a decision that creates a platform for us to start to think about ourselves as caring citizens for the University of the Free State. The Chair of Council also indicated that the project caring hasn't been fully deliberated on, and it will be up to the university's institutional multi-stakeholder group to conceptualize the detail of the project, which obviously will be shared with the council, and in due course will also be shared by the media. But what is clear is that council have given overwhelming support for this recommendation and ultimately the decision, and also overwhelming support for the project caring to be taken forward. So I don't know whether the Deputy Chair of Council would like to say a few words, and then we will open it up for any specific questions that you might have.
No, not really. A lot has already been said, and I think all the due processes, you know, and we are where we are, and we're hoping that this sets a good example, you know, moving forward, you know, to the rest of society on how to handle such issues.
I would just like to commend the director in terms of the detailed attention that was given, took place over an extended period of time. But if it wasn't for personal drive and personal involvement in this whole project, we would not have been at a place where we are today, where we think that we've taken one very big step forward in terms of bringing extremities in terms of opinions together.
Right, so maybe if there are any specific questions that you would like to ask, you want, I deliberately didn't go into a lot of specific to the meeting. Request was made and engagements that we had. There will also be explanations. Petition was recommended, and there's also which will be available to the university community, but on request, the media could also look into that. A complete heritage impact assessment, which is crucial and important, and in fact is an expectation from the Heritage Council that accompany any legislative approvals in terms of the relocation. So all of that detail we've got and they will make it available, but if there are any specific questions in relation to that, then you're welcome to ask. I just want to make a final comment on the issue of statutes in general. In my deliberation and trying to get more professional views from researchers and experts in the field of space, statutes, monuments, symbols, and space, it became clear that in the modern society, and in fact in going forward, in that area of research, that statues is not normally the way to go, because statues often focus on a specific period. It would obviously celebrate the individual, but it will celebrate the individual in the context of time. And we're living in a society where we think changes and evolve continuously, and therefore a statue now, five generations from now, might be seen as not befitting into that evolving environment. So specifically, what we've picked up in relation to the stain statue is not about empty stain as a person. And in fact, part of the educational project was to expose everyone to the knowledge of stain and to indicate that he's not necessarily the type of person that people make him up to be. But it was good to expose that knowledge to everyone, staff and students at the university. It's what we, if we see that through the lens of people that felt that the statue itself represents the pace of transformation at an institution that we believe is a transformative institution and in a transformative society, and to what extent the symbol or the monument inhibit that integration, celebration of diversity, creating a sense of belonging, and not reminding individuals of a history that they might not have been part of, or in a history which is depicted in an angle which they might not have been exposed to. And therefore, if you're looking at modern literature, people would say that statues sometimes are erected in a way where there's a homogeneous body that have got a particular recognition or admiration for a specific person. But as time, that homogeneity becomes a heterogeneous composition, which is not targeting only looking at one specific stakeholder group. And therefore, it puts challenges on how an inclusive society look at certain monuments or symbols. But the point that I would like to make in terms of is not about winning or losing, is that the Project Caring will try to emphasize that it's not now an attack on a specific culture. It's not an attack on a specific ideology. It is to say that where the statue is situated, it provides a challenge for us as management. It's in front of the main building. It's twice the size of a normal individual, if you take normal size of the individual. And it creates a level of prominence that probably exclude a certain group of our student and staff population that might not have experienced the history in the same way. And we felt that this particular statue would probably not be promoting the type of university that we would like to see. But that doesn't, and I would like to emphasize, that doesn't mean that all of the specific memorabilia, other symbols, statues that either belong to one or other culture is now suddenly up to be removed or to be relocated. So I just, yeah, if there's any questions, then you're obviously welcome to ask that. Mm-hmm.
As
I indicated, it will be done in full consultation with the Steyn family. There is no finalization at this point in time as to where it will be relocated to. And we make very sure that we understand that there's a difference between the relocation and the removal. This conversation will also happen, and the details need to be fleshed out with the Steyn family in terms of what are their preferences and what are the logistics required to take care of that.
But does that mean that it's still going to be on the university grounds? It's going to be completely removed?
So it will be relocated off the university campus.
Yeah.
What the council have indicated is that they wouldn't like to specify at this moment where it should be relocated to, although there had been recommendations made, but those will have to be tested with the Steyn family.
Can you just explain
what
your reasoning is why the statue actually needs to be taken completely off campus? And why can't you
be
relocated to another
facility? We had four options that we assessed. The one was to leave the statue where it is, to leave the statue and reinterpret the space around the statue. And the third option was to relocate the statue somewhere else on campus. The feeling from the task team there was that if you relocate the statue to another place on campus, that will reduce the prominence of the empty stain. It will still be, because one of the other primary reasons for relocating it somewhere else, into an environment which contextualized the history in which and under which empty stain has been operating. And relocating that will still have the statue out of context in a way. Probably more so, because there wouldn't be now another building in the background that necessarily will contextualize to a certain extent the statue. So those were one of the, those were the main the two major reasons why that option wasn't recommended at all. Okay. So I think we probably have come to the end of the media conference. And I just would like to thank you, thank the media. And obviously, there would be more opportunity to have one-on-one conversations with myself or other members. Thank you for being here.